In this video on how to use Zoom on iPhone, I will show you 5 essential actions that you can do on Zoom. How to install Zoom, how to join a meeting, how to create an account, how to create a meeting, and how to create a scheduled meeting. First, how to install Zoom from App Store. For you to install Zoom on iPhone, you will need to go to the App Store, find it, and tap on it. On the App Store, search Zoom. After you have found Zoom, tap on Get. It will ask you your password or your fingerprint. Complete the requirements. Now wait. After the install is complete, just tap on Open. You have installed Zoom on the iPhone. The next step is to join a meeting or just sign up for a new account or sign in into your old account on iPhone. Now, let's see how to join a meeting. If you wish to enter into a meeting, you will need to have the ID of the meeting and also, if needed, a password. Find this info from the host. For you to join a meeting, you need to tap the big blue button, Join a meeting. Tap the ID of the meeting on the top. Write it. You can also select what join option you wish from this list. Now, tap on Join Meeting. If the meeting has a password, it will appear this pop-up. Write the password and tap OK. If the meeting has not started, you will get a screen with a message saying "Waiting for host. Please wait until the host starts the meeting. You cannot do anything until then." If the meeting is starting and you are the first time on Zoom, it will ask you to agree to the terms of service. Tap I agree. Now, Zoom will ask you some permissions. Tap OK to the camera permission. You can join a meeting with video or without. Let's tap on Join with video. Now tap OK to microphone permissions. Now tap Allow to notification permission. Now you joined a meeting on iPhone. Just tap on Call using Internet Audio to join with audio. You can start audio and video from the buttons below. Tap on the Join Audio to join with audio and then start video to see and hear yourself in the meeting. Now, let's see how to create an account. Tap on the sign up link from the bottom. Here, write the email on the first input. Then, write the first name and the last name. Check that you agree to the terms of service from Zoom. Now, tap on Sign Up. You will receive an email to verify your account. Just check your email to continue with the next step. I will go to the Gmail app on the phone. Here, we have the email that we received from Zoom. Tap on it. Now tap on Activate Account. On this page, if this pop-up appears, just tap on Agree and Proceed. Now tap Close. You can change your name here if you want. Also, just create a password for your new account. Just write the password and the confirm password. I will skip this part for you not to see my password. Now tap on Continue. Here, let's skip this step. I do not wish for now to invite anyone. Your new account is ready. Let's get back to the app so we can log in. Tap on Sign In. Here, write your email and password and hit Sign In. Now tap OK to Zoom to access your calendar. This is very useful as Zoom can add reminders to your scheduled meetings. Tap OK if you wish Siri to access Zoom, or don't allow if you do not wish this. Now tap Save Password if you wish Zoom password to be saved. You can enable Fingerprint ID if your phone has this. I will tap OK. Your new account is ready to be used. Now, let's see how to create a meeting. Tap on the New Meeting button from the top. Here, you can set up the meeting to be with video or not. For the ID, you can use your personal ID or just generate one. If you leave this option unchecked, then every time you will get a different ID for your meeting. Now tap on Start the meeting. You have started the meeting. Just tap on Call using Internet Audio to join with audio. You can invite others by pressing on Participants and the button Invite. Also, you can tap on the three dots from the bottom and select Meeting Settings to make any adjustments to the meeting. There are lots of useful features like Mute on Entry so that users have audio disabled on entry. Also, other options like Allow Person to Chat. If you want not to allow others to join the meeting, just tap on option Lock Meeting. Also, you can allow others to rename themselves and to share files. After you have checked all of the options, just tap Done from the top. This is your new meeting that you can invite others to join. Now, let's see how to create a schedule meeting. To schedule a meeting, just tap Schedule button from the top. Here, you can give a name for your meeting. You can also select a start time for the meeting and duration for this. You can make so this meeting will repeat depending on your needs. If you will enable Use Personal ID, the meeting ID will be the same as your account. If not, every time you start the meeting, the ID will reset and generate a new one. Also, you can set up a password if you wish here. You can disable also the password for the meeting if you want. After that, you can set up that the video for the host to be on, and also the video for the participants. After you have selected all of the options you wish to, just tap Done from the top. Now, you can add this new scheduled meeting to your calendar, so you will not forget. After you do the adjustments on this event, just tap Add. To start the scheduled meeting, just tap on Meetings from the bottom. Here, just tap Start for the meeting. Here, tap on Call using Internet Audio to activate the microphone. If you tap on the three dots and select Meeting Settings, you can set up more options for this meeting. There are a lot of useful features like Mute on Entry, so that user have audio disabled on entry. Also, other options like Allow Person to Chat. You can check them as the options are quite well explained. After this, just tap Done. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them on the comments area below.